So this is the verification of Stefan's law. Now what is Stefan's law of black body radiation? Stefan's law states that energy released by a black body per unit area per unit time proportional to the fourth power of its absolute temperature. So with this experiment we can determine the Stefan's constant. Now what is black body? We know that black body is such a substance which can absorb all the radiation. Not only that, if you heat the black body for a particular temperature, it can emit all the radiation. So black body is not only good absorber but also a good emitter. So for a perfect black body, the emissive power is equal to 1. Now we can consider this filament as the black body, because when you are sending some filament to this, it will emit radiation. It can emit light. That's why we can consider it as black body. So we can determine the Stefan's constant with this black body. Now, the Stefan's law of black body radiation in term of a power, we can written as P is equal to sigma S epsilon T to the power N. So this is a general expression. For a perfect black body, this N should be equal to 4, but here we are not using any perfect black body. So that's why in general it is written as N. Now P is the power released by this black body. Sigma is the Stefan's constant. S is the surface area of the black body. Epsilon is the emissivity of the black body. And T is the absolute temperature of this black body. Right? Now if we take log on both sides, then it will be sigma S epsilon plus N ln T. Right? Now this is a constant. So if we consider ln P as 1, this is a constant, say X, and ln T as X. So this equation will be a straight line. So we have considered ln T as X, ln P as Y. So this is a straight line, equation of a straight line, right? And what is the slope? Slope is nothing but the N, right? So if we can measure what is the slope, it will give you what is the value of N, and we can determine what is the power of the temperature. So it should be nearly 4, maybe slightly greater than 4 or less than 4, but it should be nearly 4. And Stefan's constant we can determine very easily if we know what is N. Then by select a particular point on this graph, we can determine what is the value of ln P from y axis and what is the value of ln T along from x axis, right? So ln P and ln T, if we know this, then by putting the value of ln P and ln T and N we already measured, then we can calculate what is the value of sigma if surface area and emissivity are known. Now surface area of this diode and what is the emissivity, that will be supplied data. So if we know all this, we can easily determine what is the Stefan's constant, right? Now what we have to do, we have to measure the power emitted by the black body and what is the temperature of this black body. Now we cannot measure what is the temperature of this black body. We cannot measure it directly because it is too high, of the order of 10 to the power 3. Now what we can do? We know that resistance has a temperature dependence. We know that RT is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha T. Now if we know what is RT, what is R naught, what is alpha, then we can determine what is T. So in this experiment, exactly we will do this. We can record what is the resistance. What is the resistance at room temperature? We can record what is the resistance at different temperature. And if alpha is supplied, we can measure what is the temperature. Now how to measure the resistance? Simple. If we know what is the voltage in the filament, across the filament, what is the current sending to the filament, then by dividing the voltage and current, we can measure what is the resistance. So that we will do. And again, power, if we know what is the voltage and what is the current, then by multiplying the voltage and current we can measure the power. So if we know what is the voltage along across the filament and what is the current sending to the filament, then by multiplying voltage and current we can measure what is the power emitted by the filament, and by dividing voltage and current we can measure what is the resistance of the filament, right? Now this is about the theory. Now how to do the experiment? So you just see there are two knots. So this is, this one is for coarse adjustment and this one is for fine adjustment, and 2 meters are given. This meter can record the filament current and this meter can record what is the filament voltage, right? Now